are encouraged, whatsoever you do in word and deed, do all in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord Jesus. That's what we are supposed to be doing. And when we do that, we become what is called the elect of God, possessing that for which we pray earnestly for this day. We pray for true religion, not this false stuff that proliferates so frequently in our broken world. I think we've all seen enough false religion in life to know the difference. We have the light of Christ. We've been proclaiming that and trying to understand it more fully throughout the season of Epiphany, when Christ manifested, made known himself to the world. And we have the light of Christ within us. We need not then stumble around in the darkness of this world. We can't say we did not see the other guy who we stepped on and crushed because he was in our way. That's the way of the world, not the way of the cross. You and I are called to put on a heart of compassion and kindness and humbleness and, yes, even long suffering. There is suffering and peril and pains that are involved in being Christ. We certainly know that, historically and in our day and age. But there is also a reward in the end for the faithful. When peace and love of God resides within us, in our heart, mind, and soul, they become our catalyst for life, both in word and deed. And guess what? The things that we thought were impossible no longer are, and miracles do occur. It was so with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. It was so with the prophets and the apostles and all the saints. And it's so for you and me also. There will come a day, we are told, and we believe, when the harvest is going to occur. The tares will be separated from the wheat, and the wheat will be taken into the kingdom of God. Do everything in your life in the name of the Lord Jesus. That's all we have to do. It is. God will do the rest.